So this is where you keep your cars.
Yeah. This is a glass house for a plant. There are chickens too over here. But now it's for storage. In the past I was a car restorer. Yeah, I have still a lot of cars actually. This is the Fiat Public. It was some kind of a bench in the waiting room for people in the...
So funny, so it actually worked?
Yeah. Yeah, it was some kind of project from Fiat to ask designers to think about cars, to use them more hours a day. I thought the cars are parked for 22 hours a day, so we have to do something with that. And this is one example, you can use it as a bench when you park it. Inside it's a cart, like a karting car. This plastic of polyester was a shape I used. I also bought a karting car and make a new chassis to fit it all together. So, when I steer it gets up.
So the idea was that you would pull this in and park somewhere and people could use it as a bench.
Yeah, that's the idea. Yeah, on the marketplace or something. Yeah, the idea of Fiat was to build something like a working place on your car. That was the idea. But I thought maybe this is better. Yeah. It's called Easy Car. You can sit in like this. A little bit lower, I think, so like this.
So do you think that we're not exploring enough with our automobiles, that we should think beyond?
Yeah, everything is possible. In the Netherlands, they store some ships upside down. But you can imagine that this shape is also perfect for car aerodynamics. It's really steerable, but... No. Yeah, the car over there, it was an anti-radar car. This was a door that's opening this way. This is a car with wind turbine in front. All the air it gets inside of this box and it has to sucked out by the wheels also. Just the air going this way.
The blades of the wheels also help the wind.
You get some kind of tornado air spin you get out.
It's a car for extreme weather, right?
Tornado car.
The wheels are working in the same position as normal wheels, but the chassis is total new. So chassis outside everybody, like a horse feet shape, actually, so like this. You get a flat bottom, you can sleep inside if you like. And yeah, I need a wide car because you have the turbine there, the wheels there, and spaces behind to let the air. It disturbs also three times as much air in the area.
So you think a concept like this could work in the future?
Yeah, I have to try, yeah. Everything is new on this car. This type of wind turbine is new with the wheels like this. There is a normal dynamo inside.
So you are using a dynamo to convert kinetic energy into electricity. This electricity goes through a battery and then from the battery to the drivetrain.
Yeah, when you park the car, you can also collect energy. Actually, the idea was to put that thing vertical when you parked it, and then it can collect air from every side. Okay, if you have.
Are you planning to finish the car and test it on the road?
That's more a dream, I think, yeah.
Thank you.
This is Utrecht, the river, the Vecht. When we studied, some people start to buy ships and to live here. My girlfriend bought this ship then.
I was a student when I bought this ship and it was very bad. And the way we just put it here, without any costs or without any regulation, because it wasn't allowed, but we just do. And now they try to make it official.
Legal, yeah.
And when it's just official and we get an address and we get water and all those things, then we have to pay for it. Mm. But till now it's free in a way.
Later on, we bought another ship. We live here on both ships.
It's 1924.
Yeah, 1924. This was from 1927. In the beginning, it was affordable. You had to buy a ship that's in this river already. But it cost a lot of work to keep them in good condition, or to bring them in a good condition, actually.
So it was an old tugboat?
Yeah, it's old tugboat. I have a picture of it. Upstairs it was really small. Only where the steering wheel is, was a house. The back of the ship is all open. Just a cover for the engine there.
I love this thing.
Yeah, this is for the water. We have a big water reservoir, so you can pump it. This is the only metal part in the system, so if you don't like the taste of it, you have also a bottle with normal water there.
And you have a little cook stove here?
Yeah, this one obviously a gas bottle outside. Okay. This is an oven, electrical.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, very small. Yeah, the engine is underneath. You can easily open it. The big engine from the 60s it is. Bedroom. We covered this, so that when you walk down, the dirt's not coming in your bed.
So it has, this basically fits, sleeps too?
Yeah, or sometimes a child, let me sleep over here. Over here you can see the shape of the ship. This is all the chain for the anchor.
So is the toilet like this?
Yeah, you need to put them a little bit higher. Otherwise the water can go.
Comes up underneath?
Yeah. So you can block it like this and open it then to repair or something. And this is the water from out of the river also.
So it's just water coming in from the canal?
Yeah.
And going out?
Yeah, also over here, yeah. We have ecological paper here. We have to stop this system in a year or five, I think. So we go in the other ship, we change it this year to make a dry toilet.
I've never seen a toilet like that. It's just a little throne.
Yeah. It's a little bit higher. And in the past there was a shower over here too. So it fits on this.
So would this be something that a tugboat driver would have lived in, or?
Yeah, if he lived there, maybe for a few days or something. A big box underneath for the water tank. Like this.
That's drinking water?
Yeah.
Drinking water. Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's a deposit, huh?
Yeah. You have to check it, if it's enough.
750 liter.
Yeah, actually we built this wooden thing for to make a hard plastic thing in for 1100 liters. But when we finished the thing, the company was gone. So we couldn't make it.
So how long can you go with 750 liter?
3-4 weeks. Yeah.
And how do you fill it?
Just over here. It's outside there. This thing we had to open and fill it like this. So over here you have a bed. The top is already finished, but we have to make...
So have you ever slept here?
Yeah, mostly our two boys slept over here in the summertime when we are on holiday. But we had to make the bottom and to cover the engine a little.
Because it's down below.
The fin on this.
Oh, it's for the... Okay.
For the drivetrain.
The drivetrain. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, one of our boys finds them himself in the night over there. He was sleeping and well past this point thing.
And so what is this that you're sleeping? It's just some canvas and...
Yeah, two pipes. And the idea was that it's winter time.
Yeah.
You bring this also to there. And you can store things like this or cables and things. Yeah.
And then, it's so simple.
Yeah. This is long enough to sleep, yeah.
So it's a bit like a hammock?
Like military people use, I think, in the field. Yeah, and this is like the old style of used in ships also. Yeah.
The portholes.
Yeah.
Use every bit of space, don't you?
Yeah, you need, yeah.
Wow, so this way the boat can fit five people.
Yeah.
Whatever you have.
Yeah. One small one.
One small one.
But today we get some people on board who rent it for 4 nights.
That's great.
So the two are yours, huh? The two of them.
Yeah. We have to do a lot with the ship in this year. It stays here for 15 years now. We have to really sail this year for all kind of license. We have to make it drivable. Like all new machines like this and this and this. Everything's okay now. And only the engine had to start, have to work on it.
I like your clothesline there.
And we had to build this for the shoes also.
It feels like a house.
Yeah. It's normally, there was outside in the past. It's very small. I have a picture for the ship. So they had to live there with the whole family. There's a lot of people, they sail the ship.
Yeah.
So you can see the mast. Pole and then the cable. Yeah,
so
not for sailing, but to put the things out the ship, like a crane. You have to pick this thing. You hold the thing.
Oh, you hold that.
And
oh,
then
good to know.
It's a steep drop.
This is big here. This is what the kitchen or the eating dining room.
Sometimes we have a party setting, then we eat over here. But we use it for the children playing, studying. This is not a big ship, actually. This is the normal height. We hired it up, so we made it. I can stand over here like this. Is this the only thing you have to watch out for? Uh-huh. For your head. There you have it already.
Oh.
This we built ourselves for the heating. This will heat the water in the pipes. All the ship, actually. You have heat at every spot and yeah.
And did you put the beds
in? Yeah, we do it ourselves. Yeah, we use this metal thing like a pole for the beds. For the rest, it's hanging. Hanging on this and to that wall. So it's underneath the floor, is totally free then.
Yeah.
So you had to, sometimes you had to put it out to look if everything is okay. The floor is also new. This is also new. And the old parts of the floor and this, we built that table from.
Ah, okay.
So, yeah. And now I'm busy with this. To make until here, we like to isolate it.
Insulate. And so this is a closet.
Yeah, I like to build two rooms over here now.
Uh-huh.
Small rooms. We don't like it, but it doesn't work this way. We had to close it over here.
Yeah. To give them bedrooms.
Yeah, and the study space, easy to warm up. And this is the last part I built because in the winter time, this is getting wet and leaking.
Condensation.
Uh-huh. So it's going in this and to keep it away. This all new, I have to make it for the whole distance. This is 220 volts and this is 12 volts.
So the whole electrical equipment and everything, you designed it?
Yeah, I designed
because
myself.
You get electricity from the city
from
installation
yeah.
from outside.
That's true, yeah.
you get any sort of a storage here, energy storage, or it's just
we have batteries. After this, there's the engine and our batteries besides. This is the main room over here.
This is really light.
Yeah. Mostly everyone is over here.
Yeah. So. Oh, really? You spend most of your time here?
Yeah. The kitchen is over here. And office over here with this spot. And the bedroom over there. Office. But also we eat mostly here. Yeah.
So it's all in one?
Yeah.
Did you make anything down here? Did you put the bed together? Or?
Yeah, the bed we built. So we have all our clothing and things, playing for our girl.
And toys?
Yeah, toys and clothing.
So how about the challenge of creating a house in a boat? Is it difficult?
I think it's more difficult because it's nothing is really a square or something. And it's small also.
What's the advantage?
Is it more affordable?
We can't buy a house in Utrecht or in the environment. Maybe in the north of Holland. But the way we live, doing things by ourselves, living a little bit from art.
Yeah, you can.
To take care for our children by ourselves. So, yeah, we spend a lot of time doing things that are important for us, but don't earn money.
I also found a new form of rowing, just like this. Yeah. I learned it from canoeing. This is rowing.
Can I try too?
In a way, it's a personal investment, but it's more time and effort than economic.
Yeah.
It's a choice you
make. Yes, it's of course, every day is a choice.
She likes to have the keys back. Is it possible? Just over here is okay.
The eldest daughter, she lives in Amsterdam right now. She said never on a boat again. It's maybe not. Yeah, but it's our choice. And they do hate us. Well, in summer they do like it very much because they ask friends over to swim here in the river and to jump off the ship and to go on holiday with us. Everything is possible. So, and we have a lot of time for them. So when they said, "Oh, we like to do that," okay, we can do that.
My first idea was to live in this one, in the van.
Yeah.
The idea, when I have some tools, I can make a living when you can make it another way. Mm-hmm. Now when you look back, you can see you built everything in your life. Yeah. This is the converted Porsche, just a turnaround car. These are the backlights. This is for put fuel in it. There's also a backlight. And normally the engine is over here.
Now this is the trunk.
Yeah, even the doors are opening the wrong way, like this.
So it just seemed more aerodynamic to you to...
Yeah.
It's that different.
Yeah, because there's round shaped backside normally coming through. The air didn't get loose from the shape, so it pulls at your car.
So Porsche built the car the wrong way.
Yeah.
Really? I mean, that's a big car company.
But later I found out that they tried the car themselves in the wrong way with better results also.
And so, but they haven't changed the car?
No, no. And later on they made spoilers on it to better it a little.
So you have bikes as well?
Yeah. This is a bike I built. It's big tubes. So you only need 5 tubes to build a bicycle. So yeah, you can use this part as steering with a bell inside. You don't need a saddle anymore because this is round, such a round that you can sit on it. At this part, I make it open. Normally, the power goes to the middle and then go to the chain. I opened it so it goes directly to the chain.
And it's more efficient that way?
No, not.
Simpler?
Maybe simpler in thinking, but not in producing.
So why do this? Is it an intellectual exercise or?
Yeah, to show this is also possible.
And do you like it?
I like it, yeah. You need a little soft covering over here. Because it's a little bit steep and then you go off it. It's more like rowing. Use 2 movements this way. But when you push, the wheel goes also.
You row?
But just, you pull and push. And also with your legs also. So it goes really fast.
Faster than...
Yeah, than normal. But you use all your muscles, you can say. You can go out of your seat as well and push forwards. We call it intercity bike, so you can for longer distances. That's the idea. Wow. Oh, this bicycle, it's just a sheet of metal just over the wheel. It's only this you can use in steering things. The chain's also inside.
And that was just to keep it simple.
Yeah, no, another way of against
dirt and rain.
Yeah.
Weather, for weather.
Yeah. Some people say the bike is the best developed product, but I think you can think king farther. So you leave it and think again. Yeah, on this bike I better the system because a normal bike at this side apart for braking you had to block. So I had a big strip on this side of the bicycle, and for this one I made a new axle, so the braking part is blocked over here. So in this one there are no normal bicycle parts, only the tires. What I'm doing now, I try to make a bicycle. You don't have to step over something. You just walk inside, sit and steer. Like the bicycles for elderly people you have in Netherlands. Oh, here's the bicycle with the wind turbine in front of you.
How do you decide what's going to be your next work?
Mostly I want to do it with the wind turbine. So sometimes people ask me, how can I bike with less resistance? Then I came with this bicycle with the wind turbine. There's also a car you have not seen, like this one.
What is that?
Yeah, it's a Citroën. I built 2 of them, as if they are built from plastic totally. Yeah, it looks like plastic. I give it a structure, also for better aerodynamics as well.
Always tinkering with the different... Yeah. You don't want to leave anything alone and you have to customize everything, right? Doesn't seem like you're ever satisfied that there should be a final product. You're not happy with the conventional bike nor the conventional car. The idea is you can always iterate, you can always create something different or better.
This is a table for outdoors, but you can also use... Next week we go to Spain in the van. Use this. So this shape is also for the spare tire. And this is the missing part that you had to put over here. Yeah, we travel not that fast, so we get to look a little bit around and to park somewhere. And the traveling is an experience too. Then it's not as fast as possible to be there, but we look around.
So at one point you thought you could live in this?
Yeah.
Full time?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. But when you park it in a garage like
And
then you have a spot to sleep in, you can make your meal.
There's a sink?
It's not connected, but you can pull, give water like this.
It's a manual pump. Then,
wow.
But over here, it's in the garage. You can fit
stove.
A stove, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I do have a lot of parts like this. I have new. This I have new. One thing I made a double floor to store things in it. And one is locked also for the computer and things.
Ah, that you can lock too.
Yeah, and the little one sleeps over here. Two poles over here. Canvas.
Your daughter sleeps there?
Yeah.
The 7-year-old?
Yeah. And in the back we can do this. Right, we have some wood. You can pull it out.
Uh-huh.
And then we can, two boys can lay down here.
Ah.
And the tent is more like this. So,
so it sleeps five?
Yeah.
Wow,
yeah.
That's great.
When I look back, I can see I made everything myself.
Okay. To make it dark.
Uh-huh. This is the material you sleep on the front.
You need the poles though.
Yeah.
Everything.
Home, bikes, cars, all restored two times. I had to renew everything, only the axles.
Of course. Our original.
Yeah, I have to change everything, yeah.
So you can provide your reality.
Not that this is my idea to do it, but afterwards I can see I did it, yeah. I have to start it and try if I can move it. It isn't like to idle, but I try. The only problem is nothing is really finished, I think. I have to do something at everyone, at everything. So that's not really commercial to think this way. But
I think you're customizing everything about your life.
Yeah.
Which is, yeah, you know, not easy, but I'm assuming kind of satisfying, you know, probably.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. More like a dream spot over here. That's nice then. Live between your the things you create yourself. With this, it's not easy to drive in this narrow space. Or I had to push it a little maybe, yeah, and then try again. But it's,